Hello and welcome to Rao's IAS. This is the Daily Films Practice Initiator and here we discuss important MCQs from The Hindu and Indian Express. The topics for today's discussion are mentioned over your screen. So let's begin our session.
So the first MCQ for today is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 8 of The Hindu. The article is about how is India addressing sickle cell anemia. UPSC in the previous years has asked questions regarding various diseases. As in 2021, we found a question regarding hereditary diseases. So let us solve our practice question, which states that with respect to sickle cell disease, consider the following statements. Statement 1. It changes red blood cells into round, flexible and non-sticky cells. Now this is an incorrect statement. This is because the red blood cells, which are originally round, flexible and non-sticky, but because of sickle cell disease, they are converted into stiff, sticky and sickle-shaped. The second statement is, it is prevalent in communities residing in areas where malaria is endemic. Now, this is a correct statement. Sickle cell disease is a genetic blood disorder which is caused by mutation in hemoglobin beta gene. And as you can see in this image, because of this disease, the normal RBCs, which are round in shape, are converted into sickle-shaped. And as normally, RBCs are round and smooth, they move easily through the blood. But the sickle cell RBCs create obstructions or they block the blood flow. And also, the lifespan of these sickle cell RBCs is less as compared to the lifespan of these normal RBCs. And as a result, the body is deprived of oxygen. And because of which, this disease may cause chronic anemia, pain, fatigue, acute chest syndrome and stroke. So research and screening programs have found that the prevalence of sickle cell disease is more common among the tribal populations than the non-tribal populations in India. And the research has also found that sickle cell anemia is prevalent in the communities residing in areas where malaria is endemic. And it is also prevalent in those communities that practice endogamy. So presently, the treatment for the disease is gene therapy and stem cell transplants. Both of these therapies are costly and still in the development stages. Blood transfusion is also one of the treatment, but this is a temporary treatment and not permanent. And as per the budget presented this year, the goal of India is to eliminate this disease by 2047. So the correct answer to this practice question is option B, that is 2 only. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option C. So the next practice question for today is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 9 of The Hindu. So recently, in a significant development in particle physics, the physicists have been successful in measuring the electron's magnetic moment with extreme accuracy. And this breakthrough has raised some questions regarding the standard model of particle physics. And this will incentivize physicists to move beyond standard model to a more advanced model. In the previous year 2013, we found a question on Higgs boson particle. Higgs boson is a fundamental particle in the standard model of particle physics. So let us solve our practice question, which states that consider the following statements with reference to the standard model. Statement 1. The model describes the properties and behavior of the elementary particles. Now this is a correct statement, as the standard model of particle physics describes the properties and behavior of elementary or fundamental particles. Statement 2. It describes the four fundamental forces of nature. This is an incorrect statement, as the standard model of particle physics only describes three fundamental forces. It does not describe gravitational force. The third statement is, it explains the existence of dark matter and dark energy. Now, this is also an incorrect statement. Through the standard model, the existence of dark matter and dark energy is not explained. So let us understand a few facts relating the standard model of particle physics. So till date, it is the most successful and widely accepted theory for describing the behavior of fundamental particles and their interactions. Now the standard model describes the properties and behavior of elementary particles that make up the matter. It describes quarks, leptons and bosons. The standard model describes three of the four fundamental forces of nature. So there are four fundamental forces of nature, and out of which three are described by the standard model. These are strong nuclear force, weak nuclear force and electromagnetic force. Standard model is an incomplete theory, as it does not describe the gravitational force, which is the fourth fundamental force. And Also, it does not explain the existence of dark matter or dark energy. Hence, the correct answer to our question is option A, that is one only. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option A. So the next practice question is based on this particular news which appeared on the page number 11 of The Hindu. The National Disaster Response Force, NDRF, that was involved in rescue operations in earthquake-hit Turkey has returned to India and it participated in the Operation Dost in Turkey. So the recent earthquakes have brought focus towards the Middle East region. So the important locations in the Middle East region become important for the UPSC point of view, as multiple times we have seen MCQs based on regions in news. As in 2015, we found a question on Golan Heights. So let us solve our practice question, which states that the location known as Bab al-Hawa sometimes appears in news is best described by which of the following? Statement 1. A vast dry desert located in Iraq. Statement B. A freshwater lake in Jordan. Statement 3. A strait joining Red Sea with the Mediterranean Sea. And Statement D. A land border checkpost between Syria and Turkey. So the correct statement is option D. Bab al-Hawa is a land border checkpost between Syria and Turkey. So in this map, we can see the location of Turkey, Syria. And there is an important city in Syria known as Aleppo. Bab al-Hawa is located to the west of Aleppo. So Bab al-Hawa is a crossing in the Turkey-Syria border. So along with Bab al-Hawa, you can see another location which is Bab al-Salam. And through these two borders, UN is sending aid to the earthquake hit Syria. So the correct answer to our practice question is option D. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option B. So our next MCQ is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 12 of Indian Express. So recently, North Korea has conducted an intercontinental ballistic missile test. So in this context, let us solve a question based on the location of North Korea. The practice question states that, consider the following statements regarding North Korea. Statement 1. It shares its land borders with China and South Korea only. Now, this is an incorrect statement as North Korea shares its land borders with three countries, China, South Korea, and also with Russia. The second statement is the armistice line or the 38th parallel is the boundary between North Korea and South Korea. Now, this is a correct statement. The third statement is Yellow Sea in the east and Sea of Japan in the west forms its maritime borders. Now, this is an incorrect statement as Yellow Sea lies in the west of North Korea and Sea of Japan lies in the east of North Korea. So this would be more clear by the map of North Korea. So North Korea shares its land borders with three countries, China, South Korea, and also with Russia. 38th parallel line is the boundary between North Korea and South Korea. And the Sea of Japan lies to the east of North Korea and Yellow Sea lies to the west of North Korea. Hence, the correct answer to this question is option B. And in the year 2014, UPSC had asked a question on 10 degree channel. So the correct answer to this PYQ is option A. So the next MCQ for today is based on this article, which appeared on the page number 15 of Indian Express. So as per this article, foreign portfolio investors, FPIs, are back in the stock markets of India. And they have invested over 7,600 crore in a week ending February 17. So these numbers are not relevant for you. What is important for UPSC are the trends, whether FPIs are going outside India or whether they are incoming in India. In the year 2022, we saw that there was a huge number of FDIs which were withdrawn out of India. Now, based on this article, let us solve our practice question. The practice question states that with reference to the foreign portfolio investment, which of the following reasons would result in its outflow from India? That is, you have to tell the reasons which would result in outflow of FPI from India. Now, the first statement is higher domestic inflation in India. So, this is a correct statement. The second statement is higher rate of interest in the USA. This is also a correct statement. The third statement is global disruption due to wars. This is also a correct statement. The fourth statement is higher valuation of financial assets in emerging economies like China. Now, this is an incorrect statement. So, let us understand these statements. So, foreign portfolio investment is a kind of short-term investment. It involves investing in the securities and financial assets of a foreign country, which aims to maximize the profit. And hence, FPIs are volatile. The outflow of FPI depends on these following factors. So, if there is a high inflation rate in a country, then the investors will pull out their money from that country. The second factor is interest rate. As the aim of investors is to maximize their profit or to gain higher return on investments. Hence, investors will prefer to invest in countries with high interest rates. And as the question said, higher rate of interest in USA, then the investors will pull out money out of India. The third factor is global disruptions such as wars. So in the case of global disruptions such as wars, the investors will park their investment or money in more stable and developed markets like that of US and UK. And they will avoid the emerging markets or the developing markets like India. So in case of global disruption due to war, they will pull money out of India. The fourth factor is valuation. So higher valuation of an investment will make it more costly and less attractive. So a foreign portfolio investor will try to buy stocks which have lower valuation. Now let us see the statement, higher valuation of financial assets in emerging economies like China. If the valuation of assets in China is more, then the investment will not go out of India, rather they will come in India. Hence the correct answer to this question is option D, that is 1, 2 and 3 only. So UPSC in the year 2019 had asked this particular question. The answer to which is option D. So the final MCQ for today is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 15 of Indian Express. So as per this article, mutual fund collection through new fund offerings was 38% less as compared to 2021. So in the year 2022, mutual fund collection via new fund offering dropped 38% to rupees 62,000 crores. So UPSC has time and again asked questions regarding various financial instruments and various terms in news. As in previous year 2021, we found the news on fiscal stimulus. Now since we have read the news, it would be easier for you to solve this question. So let us solve our practice question which states that which one of the following statements appropriately describes the new fund offer. Statement 1. It is a massive investment by the government in manufacturing sector to ensure the supply of goods to meet the demand surge caused by rapid economic growth. This is an incorrect statement. It is a process by which a company which is already listed on an exchange issues new shares to the investors or the existing shareholders. Now this is also an incorrect statement. It refers to the process of offering shares of a private corporation to the public in a new stock issuance for the first time. This is also an incorrect statement. The fourth statement is, any asset management company launching a new mutual fund in the market can raise capital for the same through new fund offer. Now this is a correct statement. So let us understand a few facts about new fund offer. So let us first understand what are asset management companies. So asset management companies are the financial firms that pool in money through various investors. And after they pool this money is invested in different investments like stocks, bonds, real estates. Now this money which is pooled by AMCs is known as mutual fund. So when these AMCs want to create a mutual fund, they launch a NFO, that is new fund offer. This is more or less like an IPO in stock market. Hence, these new fund offerings are launched to attract new investors' money and to raise capital. Hence, the correct answer to this practice question is option D. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option B. So, this brings an end to today's session. Stay connected for more video updates. Thank you.